Hello and welcome to the BDMS Wellness Clinic. I'm Dieter Burkhardt and it is my privilege to bring to you a special clip we're calling Ask the Experts. Today we're joined with Dr. Tanupon Virunhakarun, Chief Operating Officer of the BDMS Wellness Clinic. We're also joined today by Professor Jiří Dvořák, Medical Consultant for the BDMS Wellness Clinic. Today we're going to be talking about brain health, what supports it, and how do we improve it. Dr. Tanupon, your patients must come to you with this question often. What do you recommend for brain health?
The most important thing, in my opinion, is the sleeping. Because, you know, when the bodies have the problem, you can exercise, you can do a lot of things, but when the problem is happening with the brain, the most important, in my opinion, is you should have a very good quality of sleep, 8 to 9 hours a day. And you should go to bed before midnight. The best time is should be about 10 p.m.
We hear a lot today about foods that are specifically good for the brain, or brain foods they call them. Are there any recommendations that you have? Is there such a thing as brain food?
When you have a very good sleep, that's the number one. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now the second is, what is the food that give you the benefit to your brain? You can select and you can choose for the fish oil, like the omega-3, omega-6. You can choose for the lecithin, improve the brain function. You can choose for the acetyl L-carnitine, is helping the brain to, you know, circulate and, you know, the brain function more. So this is a thing that you can find more information. But yeah, if you're asking me one or two or three things that help the brain, it should be the thing that I tell you.
Mm-hmm. Great, thank you.
I recommend to my patients 7 to 8 hours good sleep. Mm-hmm. I personally go to bed if I can, even with my very busy life, mm-hmm. before 10 o'clock at the evening.
Yeah, should be good.
Every minute before the midnight counts like twice as much as after the midnight.
Agree.
For those who can arrange in their busy life, very important is the midday nap, power sleep.
Power sleep.
7-10 minutes. And mm-hmm. you can learn how to fall asleep within 1 or 2 minutes. Mm-hmm. If you can achieve that, it's like after the power sleep, you are fresh again. This is what I exercise throughout my life. Yeah. Even though when I travel a lot, I have jet lags mm-hmm. and all that, you can compensate. Mm. That's the one. For the supplements,
yes.
One of the scientists provided evidence that for the brain, and it's very interesting, that dark chocolate.
Dark chocolate.
Mm-hmm. will support the brain function. Mm-hmm. Normally, we are not really supporting the sugary stuff and chocolates, yeah, but yeah. here, interesting, that mm-hmm. there are certain substances mm-hmm. which are helping. 10-15 grams a day.
Okay. Because in my opinion, the dark chocolate have the ingredients called the serotonin. So the serotonin can change to the melatonin, and the melatonin make the brain sleep deeper. So that's why I agree with Professor Jiří also that, you know, dark chocolate, make sure it's dark chocolate, not just 10% chocolate and 90% sugar. Okay, that's the recommendation.
Still good very news good that one. Brain food can also be delicious food.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much. Professor Jiří, you've been involved in over 380 research publications in your tenure as a professor of neurology and an expert in spine. What links have you found between exercise and brain health?
No doubt. There is a strong correlation between physical activity, exercise, and brain function. We experience that. If we are performing regular physical exercise, we feel better, we feel alert. So we have assessed in a large studies on volunteers, even healthy volunteers in different ages, men and women, from childhood till aging population, and we compared those with regular physical exercise, like 15 minutes a day or twice a week, 45 minutes or 30 minutes, three times a week. And we looked after 3 months, what is the change? That even the children with regular physical activity will improve their learning abilities, mm. their concentration. Mm-hmm. They will get the better marks in the school. So that was the first very important findings. But not only for the children, mm-hmm. for the adults and also the aging population. There are even a suggestion and starting to have an evidence that regular physical activity mm-hmm. might delay the onset of degenerative process of the brain cells, mm-hmm. which even if we hypothesize, mm-hmm. might even have impact mm-hmm. on the development of Alzheimer's disease. So there is hope, and we have to take it. So the evidence, we have at least a strong evidence mm-hmm. from randomized clinical mm-hmm. trials
yeah.
that the brain function improves with regular physical activity. Mm-hmm. And if you combine that with a mm-hmm. good sleep,
yeah.
as Dr. Amp recommends, then you are best set for the future.
I love this information also because my team, we read the papers and we research about this. And in my experience, the physical exercise, physical activity, everything that you've done in the daily routine could be delay the onset of the Alzheimer's disease for almost 10 years. So it's very important for the physical exercise, physical activity. Anything you can move is very important for your healthy bodies and mind.
That's fantastic. And when you talk about improving your cognitive ability, we're talking about concentration?
We talk about the concentration, we talk about the memory, mm-hmm. we talk about the brain performance, and indirectly also the intellectual capacity. Mm-hmm. And this is for many people is so important, particularly when you are getting into the 6th, 7th, or even 8th life decades. Mm-hmm. So we have to prepare. And what we have also experienced, that it's never too late to start.
I love this word, it's never too late to start. Never too late.
Thank you, Dr. Tanapon. Thank you so much, Professor Jiří. Thank you all for joining us, and we hope to see you for our next round of Ask the Experts.